When it comes to birth control, there are a wide variety of options, from the pill to the patch, the ring, the shot, IUDs, and the list goes on. It's so confusing.
Yeah, Dr. Wendy McDonald is here to break down the difference between hormonal, non-hormonal options and what works best for you. Welcome back.
Thank you.
How do you figure out what works best for somebody, because there is so many options
There's
out there?
There's just not a one-size-fits-all approach. Right. So I looked to see, like, what's the most prevalent, you know, birth control options in the U.S., mm-hmm. and we're talking about the pill, female sterilization is up there, IUDs, okay. and then there's like condoms. So those are the top four.
Okay.
But there's different types of pills, there's right. different types of, you know, IUDs, and so there really isn't one way to approach birth control.
So you really need to be with a provider that's willing to kind of go through this trial and error with you, right?
Trial and error, and what are your goals? Like, for yeah. some people, it's just contraception, right? For some people, it's cycle control, mm-hmm. it's mood stability, sure. it's skin care. So mm-hmm. birth control is not just birth control.
It's okay. true. Yeah. So I know, at least with the pills, there's hormonal and non-hormonal. Mm-hmm. Hormonal. What is the reason for using one or the other?
Well, there's not a non-hormonal pill.
Okay, there's not. Okay.
Yeah, because
okay.
all the pills are hormonal.
Okay. Oh, I didn't know
the
that.
Pill, yeah.
Okay.
But there's non-hormonal, like IUDs, implants.
Oh. Okay.
The female or male sterilization is non-hormonal, obviously.
Okay.
And there's actually non-hormonal gel as well, which is, you know, new and pretty fancy. But the reason why a person would potentially use a hormonal contraception option is really depending on, again, their goals. If you're trying to stop yourself from ovulating, that may be because you want to obviously not get pregnant, but it also could be because you want to control your skin
oh.
or your mood or even something like ovarian cysts.
Oh.
You may want to like damper that versus somebody who just wants contraception and maybe they can't be on hormones. Maybe they've had a history of breast cancer. Maybe they have a history of blood clots or something where they just can't be on a hormone or don't want to be on a hormone for whatever reason. There's just, you know, kind of ways to approach.
Right.
And it's very confusing if you're speaking to the women elders in your life too, mm-hmm. whether that be a mother or mm-hmm. grandmother or a mentor,
yes.
because when you talk about hormones with them, they have maybe a very negative reaction to hormones
yes.
because hormones have changed generationally,
they
right?
They have. So we talk about like the Women's Health Initiative, which was a big study back in the 90s that talked about hormone replacement therapy, specifically
right.
for menopause. And when they released the data, it sent people into a tizzy because it really looked like hormones were the devil, right? Like hormones caused breast cancer, they caused blood clots, they caused all these things. Only to realize that the difference in risk had more to do with dosing and age that we were using these hormones. So now that we have had a chance to not only re-examine that data, but have so much more data, we know hormones are actually pretty safe.
Yeah.
And we don't need to suffer, you know, and not have something to kind of reduce some of our symptoms.
Because now you're even seeing studies that are doing with women in their 60s and 70s staying on hormones just because of all the health benefits that come with them.
And it's possible. It depends on, of course, a person's risk factors, right?
Yeah.
Like
mm-hmm.
if you have like history of heart attack or certain types of, you know, comorbidities, you may not want to be. So that's why it's important to be with a healthcare provider that can look at your particular circumstance. But you are correct. There are people who are in like those older ages,
mm-hmm.
more seasoned ages,
yeah.
that are able to stay on hormones.
Oh. All right, Dr. Wendy, if you're watching and you're not familiar with her social media platform, it is incredible.
Yes,
I
it
love
is.
Watching it because you keep it real.
I try.
You speak in language that people understand and you talk about problems that are very taboo.
Absolutely.
And that is so fantastic because it's a source for people to turn to when they are maybe a little embarrassed to talk to their family
mm-hmm.
or
exactly.
their friends about it. But let me tell you, I mean, when it comes to birth control, I've had friends that have told me the pill made them crazy.
Okay.
Like, actually made them feel unhinged.
Absolutely.
Yep. And then I've had friends that say the pill calms them down.
Yes.
Then I've had friends that told me the IUD just caused them
all sorts
big
of problems.
Imbalances, mm-hmm. imbalances down there. And
I
then
saw a TikTok recently that said cilantro is either delicious or tastes like soap.
Yes.
Have you seen that?
Yes.
That's birth control. That's birth control. It either is amazing or not, and depends on the person and what you use. So to your point, like, I have an IUD and I love it. I have some people who would not touch an IUD with a 10-foot pole because of either their experience
yeah.
or their fears. And so there really is a need for trial and error to have an open mind and to be able to like try and see, does this work for you? Because you're right. Literally, mood specifically can either get better or worse on birth control.
Oh, that's so fascinating. Mm-hmm. I know women who've had IUDs and they had immediately taken out because they were uncomfortable.
I am on my second one and I've had it for over a decade. I'm telling
really?
You, love it.
That is crazy. Okay.
And I hear a little bit difficult to put an IUD in, but easy to take out.
Yeah, it depends on the person and it depends on your reproductive history as
okay.
well. And there's also some technique involved, I will just say. I think okay. that it's not always, you know what I'm saying? Some
yes.
people, I've had people who are like, oh, the last IUD I had was terrible. And then when I place it, it's okay. You know what I mean?
Yes.
And I'm not saying that it's just me, but I'm just, you know.
Mm-hmm. But you are good.
Yeah.
She's good. She's the best. me. So awesome to have you back. Thanks for coming on. At Dr. Everywoman is her social media handles, and she's at loopobgyn.com. You can get more information from her there.